Hello, good morning, welcome back to Sim UK and welcome back to Lake, hopefully. Yes, we've actually got a camera on today. How long it lasts, nobody knows. It could cancel at any moment. Ideally I'd like to put this down the other side. So let me just fix this for a second. Bear with me. We'll stick it down there. There we go. Problem solved. Now I'm not taking up all the screen. Cool. Alrighty, let's get on and do it. So Frank's back. That's good news. He hasn't gone to jail. I actually thought he was going to go to jail. I'm not sure what's going on there. Still think there's something weird going on. Part of me feels like maybe he's actually trying to help people. And the part of me feels
good
like.
Good morning, Providence Oaks. P.O. positive or pet peeve?
And then there's part of me that thinks maybe he's
actually no.
Like a major gangster, yeah. Or something. Jack, I don't know which is reality. I guess we'll just have to keep playing and find out.
In my store. If you don't like it, just leave.
Thank you much, Nancy. And, well, if you're asking, it's not like people have other places to go besides the smokehouse that you call a general store.
That's kind of funny. I love these little interactions in the morning. They are a bit of a giggle. That must be a really cool thing. I mean, if you really do live in a small town, USA, like this, then, you know, when the radio comes on, they are going to be talking about people you know. And that's kind of, it's a bit of a giggle. I think so, anyway. I'm sure there are negative connotations to that as well, but as long as it's not you that's being laughed at, I'm sure it's fine. Keeps you honest, doesn't it? Keeps you honest. Keeps you down to the ground when your friends can laugh at your many foibles. Whenever I go out for a drink with friends of ours, there's no holds barred. It's a any silly behaviour that's been reported will be brought up and used against you. No problem at all. This is a nice house. Kind of British looking with that brickwork at the bottom. Most American houses, I think, are... Oh, crap. What does it say on the parcel? Is it 402? Yeah, most American houses are sort of wood-based, aren't they? A lot of timber in American houses. British houses used to be made out of wood till the fire of London. Oh, hello.
Driving along the highway.
Hello? Friday delivery day.
Friday
well,
already?
Just call me Friday Delivery K. Okay, no, that sounded better in my head.
Someone's in a good mood today.
Yes, thanks for looking after Max and Gracie last night.
Oh, I forgot about that.
You were a real trooper for stepping in last minute.
No problem at all. They were great.
No problem. They were great.
I appreciate the lie.
So, how was the concert?
Oh, yeah. Man, Journey is so good. Those songs have been stuck in my head all day.
Yeah, but Journey?
I know, right? There's just so much cool stuff being created right now, you know? I mean, Journey was cool. I got to know them through Barry at first, but I tell you, if Prince or New Order ever came to Portland, I would sell my spleen for tickets.
Okay.
One spleen, two bands. That's quite the potential dilemma.
Oh, and I haven't even mentioned Cyndi Lauper. Or
Cyndi
Run DMC.
Lauper.
Or
Run
Stevie
DMC.
Wonder. And before Stevie you go Wonder. There, I know you're probably setting up a joke about spleens and Hammond organs right now.
Joke's on you, because I don't even know what that means.
You know, music organ, body organ.
Never mind.
All jokes aside, though, I spent half the concert thinking about how I haven't really focused on my own music for a while now. Kids, work, all that stuff. So much going on. And I mean, I love tinkering, but right now, I'm not sure I'm even creating anything cool or just... You know? Not even Barry is allowed to listen to my songs at this stage, to be honest.
I'd love to hear your music sometime. I'm sure it's great.
Thanks for the vote of confidence. Maybe I'll hold you to that. I was thinking, I have a mixtape with some of my stuff, you know? Just something I've been trying out with my new synthesizer.
Cool.
I'd be honored.
That's great. It's just something I've been playing around with. Don't expect any fireworks. And hey, don't tell me what you think yet, yeah? You'll be my secret special audience of one, so I can get used to the idea of an audience.
Would this have anything to do with Sunday evening?
Okay, don't tell anyone, but I'm thinking of performing a song on my new synth this Sunday. Holy crap, I just said that out loud. Dude, you are coming to the open mic, right?
Of course, that's great. Wild horses couldn't drag me away.
But act cool, yeah? No one else knows yet. See you there.
Sure thing.
Keeping it cool.
Have a great day.
Thanks. You too.
Have a great day. It's very American. I say it to people in Britain. They always look at me funny. Have a nice day now. And they go, yeah, all right. But deep down inside, secretly, they love it. They're like, oh, that's, that was nice. And then maybe, just maybe, they actually go and have a nice day. Wouldn't that be good? Be excellent. Wishing somebody to have a nice day and then they have a nice day, they might think you've got special powers. You could be the special, the happy special day maestro. I don't know what I'm saying now. Oh man, in my head that made sense. And then when it came out of my mouth, it was just complete gibberish. It made me giggle. I'm going to say that's a DeLorean, but that's not what I meant. A Lincoln, I was going to say. It looks like a Lincoln. Right. Pustage. So hang on, if I've got her tape, can I listen to it in the truck? Has the truck got a tape player? This is the 80s, by the way. No CDs, no digital FM. The digital radio, whatever they call it these days. Okay, so a bit of a mixed bag of deliveries. Let's go down here to the bait shop first. And then we'll come back on ourselves. I am now curious. What happens if I... Well, apparently, according to this game, I'm also bi-curious. But now I'm actually curious about whether or not I can hit pedestrians. And if I do, what happens? Because I hit that deer. Remember when I hit the deer? That was an incident and a half. But will the same thing happen? Or will something... Well, like, I don't know. I mean, I could get into trouble. Oh my god, the state of it. I wish this van took damage. Because I could see all the bumps and bruises that that I've caused. That would be excellent. Does he need a parcel? He does. 400 East Lakeview Boulevard. That's the last parcel for the day.
That's lighter than I thought.
Nice easy day. That looks like a GMC to me. General Motors. Oh, hello. He's actually coming down to greet us. I didn't know he could walk. That's cool. I wonder if he... excuse me, rude man. Can you not see me? Are you ignoring me? What's going on? Mr. Mackey?
Ah, the waxworms have arrived.
Excuse me?
Excuse me?
I meant the package, Miss Weiss. It's my worms. For fishing. They're just in time. I'm taking a boat to the island this afternoon.
Oh, cool. Can I come?
Oh, nice. A boat trip.
Hey, you can tag along if you want, like your father used to. but I'm not helping you with any wax worms.
Oh, yeah.
Really? Sounds like fun.
Yeah.
Okay, we'll show up here at 4 p.m. sharp.
Brill. Yay, we're going to do some fishing. Now, in reality, she might not be like that, but I will. I like fishing. Well, I see. I liked fishing. I mean, no, actually, I do like fishing. But, oh my god, look at the size of those screws. You creepers. Yeah, so when I was a kid, probably up to about 16, when I moved out of home, I always had a fishing rod. I used to go fishing with my uncle, used to go fishing with my friends, used to go fishing on my own. I just love fishing. I don't really know what happened. But, yeah, now I... kind of put all that stuff up. Well, I say I put it away. I didn't put it away. I left it with my mother. And she threw it all away. And that kind of ended me. I mean, I had bait boxes, I had ledges, I had weights. Oh my god, I do like fishing. Oh man. I don't know if I could fit fishing into my life these days. I've got simulated fishing. Oh my gosh. I wish dents appeared in this truck. Yeah, simulated fishing I like. I should definitely get on that, you know. Simulation fishing is almost as good, I think, as real fishing, because you haven't got all the stress. And there is stress in fishing. You care what you say. Plus, I don't think I've got the skill set to catch real carp in real life. I don't know, maybe I do and I've just never tried. But I can definitely catch some whopper fish on a fishing simulator. It'd be nice if there is actually some fishing in this. I'm really hoping there will be. That'd be a massive plus for the review, I can tell you that. But then, if it turns out to be like the potato fishing... The potato fishing. Oh, man. I do like fishing. Yeah, if it turns out to be like the potato farming, where nothing actually happens, it's just mentioned but doesn't exist. Hey, look, there's my old truck. Then yeah, that'd be a little bit disappointing. It is quite cool though that the truck is there, because that kind of, from an immersion perspective, which is important to me when I'm playing games, that's quite a key one. Because the truck didn't just vanish somewhere, you know, she reversed it, parked it up, and she's working on it. Oh my god, I'm gonna hit it. Oh, that was so close. Ha-ha. Wobbit! Where is he? Still trying to chop down that bush. Are we going to have a little cutscene here or not?
Meredith.
Yes, we are.
Hey, Robert.
How are you? I was away for a few days on an urgent job out of state.
I'm good. It's nice to see you again. Here's the mail.
Thanks, and likewise. Priority mail from Town Hall. Let's see what they have to say this time. Dear Mr. Harris, on behalf of yada, yada, yada... Concerning Environmental Management Act 1213, yada yada yada. Wait. What? Listen to this. We have decided to postpone the construction of apartments for at least 6 months. We hope this satisfies you, as well as the many residents of Providence Oaks that contacted us with their unfiltered and enthusiastic comments.
Unfiltered.
It worked. The plan worked.
That's funny. Wow,
oh, great! So happy for you, Robert.
We need to celebrate this. How about tomorrow night? Steak dinner at Moe's. Or something else. On me.
Something else on you? That sounds a bit kinky.
Sure. Yeah.
Great. It's gonna be fun. See you tomorrow night, then. Gotta go now. The telephone troops need to know the assault can be abandoned.
Good stuff. Only 6 months, though. Yeah, I'm going to try and be a bit hard to get, I think. because, oh my good God, what's her name at the video store? Well, I don't know where she is now, but she was quite keen. I mean, she was definitely keen. She was super keen. She was easy picking, as they say. But Robert, a little bit slow on the uptake. Don't know what his problem is. I don't know where his allegiance lies. No, it just doesn't make me feel wanted. Oh man, this is funny. Getting in touch with my feminine side, it's all good. Never holds my hand, never buys me flowers, not romantic, you know, the usual stuff. You women have it tough, don't you? Goodness me. Oi! I don't want to be too high maintenance, though. That's not good either. Are there any deers today? No deers on Death Corner today. That's good. This is our last drop-off for today's shift.
Whew. Finally done.
Nice, and she even sort of acknowledges that. That's brilliant. There are so many good things about this game. I mean, really, really very impressed with it. I wonder if they're going to release additional chapters or something like that. That would be nice. Continue the story, have new people move in. I mean, potentially the game's got that capability. Although, having said that, I do think it needs... If they were to do something like that, then I think it would need a little bit of improving. Maybe a jog button when you're not carrying a parcel. There's a few bugs. Obviously, the game crashed in the last episode. But first time and the only time it's done it. So it might just be literally that one incident that causes it. In which case, the game is very stable, but it's got one bug that crashes the game. Oh, what's happened to my driving? Improved. So, yeah, no, I think the game's really good. Let's see if they're there. Oh, just caught that at the last second. If they've actually gone or whether they're still there.
I remember Dad telling me, Meredith, the picnic area is for the older kids.
But they've actually gone, which is cool.
I had my first actual picnic here. It rained.
It rained on our first picnic. Well, that sucks. I've noticed the truck is going slower as well. I mean, the game itself, I think, is great. I really like the game. But if this were my game, I'd start having palpitations about, what could I do to improve this and make it more realistic? Obviously, I'd start going down the route of, well, let's have a first-person camera. Let's allow animations into the truck. So when you're getting in and out of the truck, it's animated instead of a cutscene. That would, I think, be my priority. Be able to sit in the truck and drive. Then, obviously, I'd want to have wheel support. I think that would... I just think it's good enough a game to warrant that kind of development. But I don't imagine we'll see that. I would love to see that, but I don't imagine we will. Maybe for their next game, they can think about what more they can do. Well, like I say, if they do go down the... Oh, let's test it. Oh, my God! It wouldn't let me! I swear to God I'm trying to run her over. Wow. Fishing.
So... Is this a quiet day, or does it always take this long?
Fishing requires patience. We've only been here for 2 hours.
Oh, wow. Barely started.
And that's the nice thing about fishing.
Well, there's a fine line between boredom and relaxation.
Yes, there is.
I find it hard to relax sometimes.
And that's true.
Fishing also requires silence.
Okay. Grumpy much?
Bert, can I ask you a question?
Do you know how to fish?
Do you like Maureen?
We ought to be heading back home. It's been a fine day, and I thank you for the company.
I don't think that went very well. And we didn't catch any fish. That's a bit disappointing. I was hoping for some real fish in there, but...
Kay's tape. Let's have a listen.
Let's have a listen. What happened there? My controller just turned off suddenly. Weird.
Okay. Okay.
Driving along the highway, headlights light up the signs, thinking of what might happen. Radio keeps track of time.
She's got something.
Hello?
Hi, Meredith. Guess what I signed today?
The contracts for the Adit 87 deal?
Oh, yes.
Get
You're
in.
Now talking to Steve Mitchell, CEO of a multi-million dollar enterprise. But before I continue my insufferable bragging, I have a thing or two to say. To
You're fired.
About you. You've been a huge part of the success of this company. And I feel this is just the beginning. We're entering the golden age of personal computers, and we've got front row tickets. The past 2 weeks have made me realize that I couldn't have done it without you. And I'm going to need you even more in the coming years. So here's a new monster deal I want you to think about. Become a partner in the company for 20% of the shares and a significant pay raise. Significant. The only condition is that I need your commitment for the next 5 years. So, There it is. Think about it, and let's talk about it more when you're back in the office.
This is a bit of a surprise.
Just let it sink in a bit. I don't need an answer right now. I have to get back to my million-dollar lifestyle. Actually, no, I need to get cranking on lots of stuff. Talk soon, Meredith.
Well, if that doesn't put the cat among the pigeons. Let's read up on our book. I'm
the
interested.
The Countess and the Carpenter.
What happens
Chapter
next?
4.
No one screws better than the carpenter's apprentice.
Old Mr. Nabenshoe acted like he was an expert on the topic.
What he's done back there is nothing short of astounding. I'd hire him for any job, and I'd pay good money for it. I never expected that the fence he repaired would survive last night's storm.
Well, I never. So many double entendres, I can't even begin.
A postcard? From Angie?
Miss Meredith, I am so, so sorry I haven't been able to see you. It's just that I've been swamped organizing my not-so-timely exit from Providence Oaks.
Angie.
I'm sure you understand. You've probably seen the foreclosure notice. That certainly helped expedite my decision to leave. Anyway, I'll be honest. I'm still thinking about that kiss we shared in the car.
Me too.
And I don't usually dwell on these kind of things.
Really?
So,
that's a bit
feels
worrying.
Special, Meredith. I hear you're going to the open mic night on Sunday. I wasn't planning on going, but I want to see you before I leave. I'm really anxious to find out what you've decided to do. Whether you're going to stay in this town, or go back to the city, or do something else entirely. And I'm going to be forward, as you know I always am.
Yes.
I'd like to know if little old me figures into those plans, somehow. So, anyway, I'll see you there, yeah? Love, Angie.
Wow. That's got to be one of the biggest postcards in the world. How on earth did she manage to write all that down on a postcard so that it was still
Happy
legible?
Saturday.
Happy Saturday. Okay, so it looks like we're going a little bit of everywhere. We'll be doing a full lap.
Everyone,
full lap.
It's time once again for a
PO positive report. That's me.
Today's verdict is from Cheryl.
Hey, hey, hey.
I went for a walk the other day and suddenly encountered a majestic stag.
I saw that stag. I ran it over.
Oh, that's heavier than I thought.
Is she not going to finish that sentence? Oh, that's a shame. What happened with the stag? Hey, Nancy. How's it hanging?
I managed to get the machine to work. Here are the pictures.
Oh, see, now that's pretty cool. Isn't that cool? I like that. Captured the birds. More birds. One without the mountain in. Moe's Diner, that's cool. I like that. I think I took a good picture there. That's probably my least favourite. It felt cooler at the time. Yeah, I think I could have done a better job of that one, actually. That's nice, though. And that's like a family picture, that one. Yeah, that's pretty good. Thank you.
Thank you. I'm happy with how they turned out.
If you'd have picked them up earlier this week, you could have participated in a photography contest.
Oh.
Really? I would have loved that.
Did I not
you
come back early enough?
You can probably only win contests like those if you're a professional.
I'd like to think that talented casual photographers also have a decent chance.
Well, one can always dream.
Yeah. Back in the day, you really needed to be a professional to take good photographs. But these days, with digital cameras the way they are, mobile phones the way they are, you can get some absolutely quality snaps without too much issue. Okay, let's do it the other way around today. We'll finish up posting all the local ones. And we'll go and post everybody else's first for a change, just to mix things up, you understand. Keep things sweet. Oh, look at this car. Looks like the General Lee. Really does look like the General Lee. That's so cool. It's Dukes of Hazzard, by the way, guys. Daisy Dukes.
Here's your mail.
Bet Meredith would have liked Daisy Dukes. Bit of a shame we can't listen to our friend's tape in the truck. Oh wow, I got it to proper power slide in then. Honestly, the more you drive this truck, the more you realise what it can do. Because initially it doesn't feel like it goes around corners at all, but if you know how to push it, it really will. Oh, parcel. Vintage Street. Every time. When will I learn?
All right, I'll leave it on the doorstep.
Notice how it's not raining under the porch? So many games get that wrong. Dude, you've left your lawnmower outside. Gonna rust. And this person's left their bicycle outside, which has got no spokes. Have you seen those bikes with no spokes? They are very, very cool looking. I'm not really into bikes in a big way, but they are something else. It's got like a clampy bracket that clamps onto the wheel and rotates the wheel through that. But there's no spokes. I don't know how it works, really. You'd think the wheel itself would collapse under the weight, but it doesn't seem to. It must be heavy, though. It must be heavy, surely. Either that or they're using an incredibly resilient, strong metal that's really light, in which case it's probably going to be really expensive. Ooh. Car took a while to render in. Oh, totally lost it. I had that corner right up until the last second, I think. Just kept the old power on a little bit too long. Right, is this Robert we're heading up to here? I think it is, but... not. No, it's not, is it? I'm not sure we've been down here. Oh, is this the... is that Death Corner? God, I'm not where I think I am at all. Where's the postbox then? Ah, I see it. Hey, come on. You could just chop down that little bush, couldn't you? Hey? Make it a little bit easier for your postal delivery service people. Oh my god, what is going on? Invisible barriers. I think it's official, we no longer care about this truck. The way I've driven it into just about everything there is to be driven into. Whoa! I'm sorry about that. Alright, we're going to have a race here, Sunny Jim, and I'm going to win. As I always do. Alright, it's computer nerdy guy time. See how rude and disrespectful he is today. Oh, hey, it's our friend. I'm not sure you're going to find anything there, bruv.
Hi there. Have you found anything today?
Oh, hi. Yeah, a few things. Nothing spectacular. A bottle cap, two nails, and a screwdriver.
Ah, okay. Well, good luck.
Thanks. See ya.
Crazy Englishman. Is it a parcel? Yes, it is a parcel. Right, I'm going to be really rude to this guy. Just because I don't like him much. Unless, of course, he's polite, in which case...
I'm busy.
Aren't we all?
No! Damn it! I almost had it. I almost fucking had it. Thanks for breaking my concentration.
Lady present.
Ooh, take it easy. It's just a game.
Video games are supposed to be fun. I feel horrible. Absolutely horrible.
Maybe you should try a different hobby.
You know what? I can beat this damn game, and I'm not quitting until I have.
Okay.
Yes, well, who told you games had to be fun? I like games to be challenging, I like games to be interesting, I like games to be realistic. I'm not sure fun really factored to my game choices. I don't know. Not sure if it does. I think, you know, I'm a bit of a workaholic, so driving a truck, being a parcel delivery guy, I'd love to do all this kind of stuff. I think the thing with me is I get get bored doing the same thing every day. Really bored. I've never really sort of acknowledged that before, so that's quite an interesting point. But yeah, I mean, if I could just swap, you know, today I'll drive a bus, tomorrow I'll drive a truck, next day I'll drive a train, then I'll fly a plane. I mean, that's, I mean, where can you get a job like that? It doesn't exist, does it? But that's where, that's where it comes in for me. I was trying to take a shortcut, and it works, look. How cool is that? I'm just experimenting now. How far can you take the truck? I mean, what? Okay, I can't go up there. What are its limitations? Wish I had a handbrake. That would be nice. Look at that. Kind of skid. Right, what are we doing? Mail? I think it's mail, isn't it?
Okay, fellow Providence Oakians, it's time once again for the sent in letters and announcements. This one's from our very own Maureen, or Mo, as we all know.
Hey, folks. Just wanted to grab your ears for a second to let you know all about the upcoming open mic night over at Mo's Diner this Sunday. That's right. Claim your 15 minutes of fame, enjoy some swell performances, and the usual good food and drinks for everyone. I expect to see all of y'all for a great evening, and maybe even some dancing. You know who you are. Come join the show at Moe's at 8 p.m. this Sunday. I'll come get you if you don't.
Well, you heard her, folks, and I'll be there too, so you better not miss it. Back to the music and to one of my favorite songs. Mail Carrier Meredith.
Farmer DJ Jack.
Seen any ghost drivers on the way here?
Ghost drivers?
Yeah, you know, people driving on the wrong side of the road.
Nope, haven't seen them.
Okay, I was just wondering. Don't bother. I need to get back to the live show. See you tomorrow, I reckon. Bye now.
Bye, Jack.
Oh, and please close the door. Don't want to broadcast any mail truck noise. Thank you much.
Thank you much. Not thank you very much. Or thank you muchly. But thank you much. Interesting. So, yeah, I think he was taking the mickey out of us, to be honest with you. I think we're the ghost driver. Oh, hang on. We do have headlights. They're automatic, of course. Oh, here we go, here we go. Ready? 3, 2, 1. That is fun. You've got to admit that's fun. Although, come on, we need some sound effects here. We need some screeching tyres. The gravel going... Yeah, this, I think this is the first time I've driven with the lights on. Got a bit of lightning. That's cool. The game does have some ambiance. The clouds moving. Yeah, the clouds are moving though. Well, that's good. Actually got a skybox. And I can see the lightning flickering against the side of the mountain and stuff. Good little game, this. Very chilled out. Has it got replayability? I don't know. I mean, not immediate replayability, of course. It's not like the sort of game you could sit and play. You know, I can't finish this and then start it again. It doesn't have that kind of replayability. Is it this one? But, you know, I could come back and I could play this 6 months from now. No problem at all. Like a one-off storyline, really, isn't it? Wondering if I could go down the back there. Whoops. Is it just taking me a really long time to do today's shift or something? Because I don't think we've driven out in the night time like this before. Suppose we went fishing. No, hang on, that wasn't during the day, was it? I don't know. Now that's a nice house. That's lovely, I like that one.
Here's your mail.
That's probably my favourite house out of all the houses so far. What do you think I should do? Should I take the 5-year deal and all that lovely money? I mean, if the opportunity's there, I feel like you should take it. Take the money now and enjoy your life in 5 years' time, you know?
That's the last of them.
Big commitment, though, isn't it? Still, if you knew at the end of the 5-year deal you'd have a couple of million in the bank, the option to sail anywhere you want, go anywhere you like, live wherever you want to, live how you want to, do what you want to do. Quite a compelling argument. And there we go. Another ship over.
And so ends a week full of turmoil.
You can say that again.
If only the Angels hadn't lost to the White Sox, that would have made it perfect.
How much would you have won?
$876.34. Would have been a nice payday, huh? They're playing each other again tonight. Should I change the bet?
Nope. Hold the line.
Okay, let's see what happens. Maybe you're my lucky charm.
Maybe so.
Have a great weekend, Meredith. Oh, wait, this was your last day. I totally forgot to tell you, but they still haven't found someone else for the job. So, I guess, you can have it, if you want.
Wow, are you serious?
Are you serious?
Of course, and it's a great job. You know what? Think about it, and let me know Monday morning when you return your stuff. Gotta run now. Red Sox are playing the Yankees.
Right, so I guess this is going to be the last episode, and I need to make that decision. Saturday evening, so we've got Saturday, Sunday, and then Monday. Does that warrant a whole new episode? I don't know.
Hello?
You've got a bit
Meredith.
Of time.
It's your dad again. How was your time in the mail delivery business?
Oh, hi, Dad. Well, I actually really loved it.
Awesome. Maybe you should just keep doing it. Worked out well for me.
Actually, it seems like they haven't filled the vacancy yet.
They haven't? Well, you know what I'd do. Oh, hold on, Meredith.
Let me guess. Mom wants to talk to me?
Hi, Meredith. Sorry to butt in, but you're thinking about staying in Providence Oak?
Maybe.
Hi, Mom. I'm not sure, to be honest.
What are you not sure about, dear? Are other people involved? You know, any interesting ones, perhaps?
No, that's not it. It's just easy going here. The surroundings, the job, the people.
Maybe you just need a break. Or maybe this really is what you want. But whatever you decide, think long and hard on it. Oh, hold on.
I have a suspicion Dad wants to
Tequila
talk to me.
Makes me happy.
I just wanted to say, you need to clean the lint filter on the dryer every once in a while. If you never do that, it could burn the house down.
No problem, Dad. I'll make sure to do that.
Great, thanks. I sometimes suddenly worry about things like that in the middle of the night. And it's not about the dryer, of course. I want you to be safe. And I'm sure you'll be okay.
I'll be fine. Don't lose sleep over me.
Okay, Em. Take care. I gotta go. We're running out of coins again. Bye.
Bye. Like they can't wait to take it off the phone.
I hope you don't think I'm a cheapskate for having dinner here. There aren't a lot of other restaurants around, and I'm pretty sure their food isn't better than Moe's.
Don't worry about it, Robert. I love it here.
Thanks, Meredith. You're such a kind person.
Wow, he's put a shirt
Good
on.
Good evening, you two beautiful people. Ready to
Making
order?
A bit of an effort.
Ladies first.
Hi, Maureen.
Gentlemen. You know what?
It's hard to pass up a juicy T-bone steak.
Excellent choice, Meredith. And what would you like to wash it down with?
I will have...
I think I'll have a...
large whiskey. Let's
Here.
Go for a beer.
Gotcha. Robert?
The usual for me, Maureen.
All right, Robert. T-bone steak and a beer. Doesn't get any more lumberjack than that. Be right back, folks. Ashley, get the steaks out!
Get the steaks out!
Maureen's the best. Did you hear about the open mic night she's organizing?
I did.
Yeah, she only told me about it a dozen times.
I wish I could go, especially since I heard that Jack's gonna do a thing.
Jack? What's he gonna do? Give a lecture about potatoes?
Believe it or not, he's a very good ballet dancer.
Get out of it.
Yeah, right. And you're his stage manager.
No, he's into comedy. Would have loved to have heckled him. Oh well, this is a good week anyhow.
Must be nice that the apartments are off your mind for a while.
Alrighty, here are your beverages, folks. I'm afraid the food might take a little longer, as a certain kitchen helper thought the freezer was a good place for storing steaks. I really should get one of those microwave ovens to defrost them.
You seem a little stressed. Is it the upcoming open mic?
Why should I be stressed about that? It's going to be lovely. And you better be there, Robert Harris.
Maureen, I'm sorry, but I'm afraid I won't be able to make it.
I did not just hear you say that, young man. Oh,
I did not hear you say that.
I need to steal him for 2 minutes. He needs to check on some wiring for me.
Excuse me, Meredith. This is Maureen's jurisdiction. Have to obey the law.
Yes. I know she's a bit sweet on him.
So good. Thanks, Maureen, for the fantastic blueberry pie.
You're welcome. It's my way of making up for stealing you away from Meredith. Ooh, I swear. She can give quite the stink eye if she wants, can't you, hon?
Oh boy.
She just
the
vanished.
The world would be boring without her. Speaking of, are you going to miss your daily delivery round?
Yes, I probably will.
Must be nice here compared to the big city.
Do you think you'll always live here?
Nothing's for sure, but I like it here. I needed to change towns after my divorce. Everything and everyone reminded me of her.
And how are you now? Have you gotten over it?
But maybe I shouldn't bother you with the innermost feelings of a lumberjack.
Wouldn't be a bother at all.
Robert and Meredith, sorry to break up your conversation, but we're closing up early tonight.
What Gotta kind
set
of
up
diner
some stuff
is this?
For the open mic night, and I can't use any peeping eyes.
Oh, okay, Maureen. No problem.
Let me get the check for you, so I can leave you two to your lovely evening.
Can you put it on my tab, Maureen?
Anything for you, darling.
Thanks, Robert.
Don't mention it. You've helped me out so much. This is nothing compared to that. Now let's get going before Maureen gets her broom out.
He did say it was his
Meredith,
truth.
Thanks again for your help. Not sure what would
this
have
is weird.
If you hadn't come here for your mail delivery vacation.
You're welcome, Robert. I was happy to help you out.
A little help goes a long way. Hope to see you around again.
You too, Robert. Take care. But you're not leaving without a hug.
Well, I tried. You can't blame me for trying. And it's... And the typing noise is back. I could never have predicted delivering mail for 2 weeks would be like this. I've met so many new people. Some of them are really nice. Most of them are really nice. Some of them a little less so, but all of them interesting in their own way. My temporary mail job officially ends tomorrow. Regardless of the actual experience, a change of scenery always has its upsides. That probably also holds true for tonight's open mic at Moe's Diner. Here we go. Oh, check it out.
Anyway, I love this town. You know I do. So, I'm dedicating my last jokes to specific people here tonight. The first one's for Maureen. A guy walks into a bar, and dozens of slabs of meat are hanging from the ceiling. So he asks the bartender, "What's up with the hanging meat up there, man?" So the bartender says, "Ah, you're new here. Well, we like to play a game here. If you can jump up and slap a steak, the house will pay for your drinks all night. However, if you miss, you have to pay everyone else's bar tab. So, want to give it a go?" "Nah," says the man. "Those steaks are too high." This one's for our own newcomer, Meredith Weiss. So, a woman's driving down the freeway, but all of a sudden, she hears a local news bulletin warning drivers on the very freeway she's on. They're saying, "Please be advised of this very dangerous situation of a car going the wrong way." So the woman says to herself, "One car? Why, there's dozens!"
She's the one driving the wrong way.
Well, folks, wasn't that special? Now, let me know if any of you have any jokes about Jack, you hear? It's an open mic, after all.
He's funnier than him.
It's actually time for a little break right now. So come on up to the bar for some of our finest concessions. We'll continue shortly.
Mildred, how are you? And how are the cats?
Fine, on both counts, dear. Thank you for asking. So, do you like the hair?
Yes, absolutely.
Looking fine as always.
Thank you, dear. Pity it's quite the waste of time and money, seeing as how I can't stay for long.
Really? What's the rush?
What's the rush?
You see, my son decided to drop by, unannounced, and he's staying the whole weekend.
Well, that's wonderful news.
Oh, that's wonderful news.
Mm-hmm. All right, well, anyway, take care, dear. Now, where did he park the car?
Yes, it's me, Matt Kearney, in an egg brace. Real funny, huh?
Oh.
Oh, hi, Matt. What happened?
Well, I was about to send the final boss, the afterlife, but then the computer crashed. I kicked my foot out in anger and fell from my chair, and now I'm here looking like a loser.
Aw, you always did.
Aw, poor you. I hope you'll be okay again soon.
I hope so. I can't even use my computer right now.
Guess who?
Jack Burton?
Aw, now I'm going to be a disappointment. It's just me.
Even better. Though I never would have guessed.
So,
Corny.
What have I missed?
Well...
not much. Jack just did some comedy. But the final act is supposed to be the real showstopper. At least, that's what Maureen tells me.
Really? Well then, I guess I arrived just in time.
So, how've you been? Busy packing, I guess.
Super busy. Again, I'm sorry I didn't have more time to...
Hey, Angie. Hey, Meredith. Sorry to pop in like this, but I just wanted to inform you I fixed everything on the RV. She's got a new radio, I replaced some wiring, adjusted windshield wiper speed. The sea turtle is ready to go!
That's great, Lori. Thanks. I'm sure it's like she's brand new.
Well, I wouldn't say that, but you'll see. Gotta go. Later.
Interesting.
An RV, huh?
Oh, it's kind of a long story. You know Mickey and June?
Yeah.
The hiker couple, right?
Well, long story short, I've somehow gained possession of their vehicle of choice.
What?
Which, as Miss Young just described, is a perfectly adequate RV. that I'm gonna use to motor right out of this sad little town.
What?
Really? Good for you.
I gave it...
Absolutely. Come with me. I mean it. Leave this sad old town behind. And go wherever we want to go. Free spirits, the way Mickey and June intended.
Well, you are a good kisser.
There's plenty more where that came from. But at some point, you've got to give me a definite answer. You get that, right?
Right. Yeah.
Look alive, folks. It's time for the final act. It's a doozy.
Saved by the bell, babe. I got stuff to do anyway.
Okay, I'll let you know.
Dear people,
I'm annoying as hell, aren't I?
None other than our own Kay Evans will perform next. She has been writing songs since she was a little girl, and I cannot say how thrilled I am to host her first performance of hopefully many to come. I am so proud of you, honey. Please put your hands together for Kay, everyone.
Go on, Kay. Knock him dead.
This does not happen a lot, but you have left me speechless. That was Kay, people. Another round of applause.
Well done, Kay. Good girl.
Well, it's a good thing I didn't leave when Reynolds started his nonsense. This kid can sing.
Oh, hi, Mr. Mackey. Yeah, she's awesome.
Yeah, it's good to see someone flourish. But I'd rather be home right now.
Isn't it fun to step out every once in a while?
Smoking a pipe and reading a proper book is the only acceptable way to spend a Sunday evening in September.
Fair enough.
Bert, thank you so much for coming. I know you'd rather be somewhere else right now.
That's okay, kid. I don't regret it one bit. You did great. But ladies, if you'll excuse me, I'm out of here.
Good night, Bert. Thanks again.
And now for an announcement. I'm serious, so hush now. Now,
okay.
You all know that Kay has been working here at the diner for quite a while now. In fact,
what is going
she
on
was
with
my
shorts?
Anchor after Stan left us. And I think the time has come to formally announce right here that I will put your name above the door of this place, honey, where it belongs. Mm-hmm. Kay's place. Mo-K's. We haven't settled on a name yet, but...
Hey, Mo.
There you go. Another round of applause. And have some drinks with us.
You have to pay for them, of course. That was amazing.
Amazing.
Oh, my gosh. Thank you so much, Em. It felt amazing. I was so super nervous, you know? Like, shaking and all that. I'm so glad it went well.
Yeah, you did good. You did good.
Kay's place, huh? Congratulations! That was quite a surprise.
Yeah, I told you. Mo asked me like a gazillion times, right? Kind of felt right this time. We haven't hashed out any details, as you might have noticed. But it feels good, you know?
I have to hand it to you. You were great. I have to go in a bit, but let me know when the next gig is, yeah?
You're not leaving already, are you? The fun's just starting. Oh, wait. Of course. Big day tomorrow, right? You know what you're going to do?
Honestly?
I think so.
Well,
wait. I'm not good at this stuff, so I just want to say it was good to have you back these past weeks, Em. Really good. You just do what you feel you have to do. I'm just glad we reconnected. Promise you'll keep in touch? Whatever the outcome, yeah?
Of course.
And remember, time marches on.
Cross your face.
See you, Kay. Thanks. For everything.
My lovely people, the time has come for the open mic part of the evening to end. Ashley was going to do a ventriloquist bit next, but I just heard he hurt his hand back in his cabin. Let me thank you again for joining us, and there's plenty of food and drink to go around.
I'd say that was a roaring success. Well done, Mo.
I sure do hope they're keeping things proper in there while I'm taking a breather. So, you had fun?
Oh, it was great. Kay was amazing.
You said it. Oh, that girl is so talented. Oh, I'd give my big toe to be able to do what she does behind a keyboard. Oh, sheesh.
I'm
still thinking about your news about handing over the diner. Kay's place, huh? That was quite the bombshell.
That's my style. I've mentioned it to Kay, yes, many times since Stan died. She probably thought I was joking half the time, honestly. I just want to give her the option. It's hers whenever she wants it. And if she doesn't, that's fine too.
Seems like a bold choice to announce it to the town like that, though.
Ha! You know me, hon. At least all the options are out in the open now, right?
So what's next for you, now that you're handing over the reins?
Well, to be honest, I'll probably stick around the diner for now, help out, and maybe I'll try my hand at something different on the side, you know? Maybe fix up some of those cabins in the woods, rent them out. Never too old to find something new to do.
That sounds like a great idea.
Doesn't it just?
Certainly does.
How did things end up with Kay?
Kay?
You could tell me to mind my own, of course. It's just that that girl is like a daughter to me.
We talked, yeah. We really reconnected, and I'm happy we did.
Listen, you're two grown women, and if that's the choice you two ended up on, I can only respect that. Speaking of choices, you've got a big day in the morning, don't you? Know what you're gonna do yet?
Is she trying
Stick
to hook
around,
us up?
Move back?
I'm so confused now.
I think I have a feeling. Yeah.
Then you go follow that feeling, hon.
Thanks, Maureen.
I best get back inside. You take care now, Meredith Weiss.
You
take
too,
care,
Maureen.
Maureen.
So, how's it going to go? Just over an hour. I think we could probably wrap it up here. I don't know how this ends.
Good morning, Meredith. You won't believe the weekend I had. Saturday, I placed a bet on the Angels, just like you said, and won. But
result.
They played again yesterday, and I let it ride, and then they lost. They're
That's
playing
it.
Again tonight, and now I don't know what to do anymore.
Well, Frank, the pattern is obvious. And betting against the pattern pays off. White Sox.
Okay, Meredith. Thanks. I'll go with that. Speaking of gambling, I bet you're taking the job. And that's not just because you're wearing your coat.
I love the coat, Frank. But no, I'm taking it off. I'm leaving Providence Oaks again.
Oh, that's not what I was hoping to hear, Meredith. But I understand. What are you going to do?
Back to my home, my job, and my life in the big city.
So I guess you're going back to the future, eh? Computers, living in the fast lane.
Funny.
Can't say that I envy you. Although it must be nice to live close to a major ballpark. Do you need a ride to the airport?
Yes, please. I'd love to take one last look over the lake.
All right, go grab your stuff and let's go.
Is he going to drive us around the lake? That would be cool if he does. Oh, he is.
So, here we are again, heading the other way. Aren't you going to miss it here?
Probably. It feels odd to be leaving again.
I wouldn't want to leave this place, not for $1,000,000. Well, wait, no, $2,000,000 should be enough.
That's the price I fell on, $2 million.
That's a good question. Give me a big pile of cash right now and I'll feel real happy. And I'm sure it'll last a couple of days, but then it'll probably start to wear off and I'll be back to complaining about the weather before you know it. But it's probably nicer to complain about the weather when you're living in a big old mansion. Hey, what's this honking clown up to? Move out of the way, you lunatic! Wait a minute. That's Robert Harris.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, I'm pulling over.
Crazy guy.
Sorry about that, Frank. Hope it didn't scare you.
That's okay, Robert. I'm a road rage veteran. But, what's all this about?
It's not about you, Frank. I need to talk to Meredith.
I think Frank would have kicked his head in.
Okay, I'll go have a smoke.
Hey, Meredith. This is going to sound super awkward and hopeless and desperate and probably a lot more things, but I don't want you to leave. I've decided a while ago that I'm done with stuff like this, but I guess it's not something you can decide.
Stuff like this?
Yeah, you know, I'm a man, you're a woman, I like you. A lot. I didn't want to give in to it. I've been through a rough breakup once, and I didn't want to risk ever feeling like that again.
Robert, I can't just give up my career for a handsome lumberjack.
Sure you can. Stick it to the man. I mean, you know, the man in general, not me. Just hop in my car.
Oh, it's a sex, what's it called? It's a sexist struggle. Why don't you get in my car?
Why don't you get in my car?
And leave P.O.? I'm afraid I wouldn't survive a week in a big city.
So you wouldn't leave P.O. from me, but expect me to stay for you?
Do you want me to beg?
I'm sorry, Robert, but no. And I need to get going now.
Okay, Meredith. Take care. Call me. Have a safe trip.
Thanks, Robert.
Okay, Meredith, let's get you to the airport. I've got a double shift today, and the mail doesn't deliver itself.
Desperate for me to stay, aren't they? I was trying to hook up with Robert the whole time. Didn't happen. And then in the end...
Special treat for y'all. I just updated my playlist. This new song is from our very own Kay Evans.
So guys, that was Lake. And I don't play many games like this, but I enjoyed that an awful lot. I really did. I'm going to leave you with the outro, and I'm going to thank you for watching. Please hit the like button, leave me some comments. I'd like to see what these guys do next. But that was a lot of fun. I enjoyed it. Thank you. Bye for now. Until next time.
Keeps track of time. I pull up to a crossroads. I could drive on or go left, go right. Suddenly these choices make me smile. What if I just enjoy the ride?